Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear colleagues, I am Professor Hussam Al-Fallal from Mansoura University, Egypt. Our subject today is Pentacam Corneal Tomography Curvature Maps. Curvature is a measurement of the shape of the cornea and it expresses its geometric properties. Radius of curvature in millimeters is more accurate than power in diopters. Therefore, when maximum accuracy is required, for example during IOL power calculation, radius of curvature is used. On the other hand, corneal power in diopters is used to represent the refractive effect of the cornea in patients undergoing corneal or refractive surgery. The anterior corneal surface represents the most important refractive interface, and minor change, even few microns, can result in significant refractive effect. The posterior surface has a minus power of minus 6 diopters because light diverges slightly as it passes from a high refractive index medium to a lower refractive index 1. Anyhow, the corneal back surface is less important in refraction. Curvature map types. Curvature maps are usually displayed in one of two formats, axial or tangential. This depends upon what method is used to measure the radius of curvature. Axial radius for any point is defined by the radius of a sphere fit to that point and centered on the optical axis. So it has a spherical bias, that's to say, consider the cornea is a part of a sphere, hence not accurate in the peripheral aspheric cornea. Local or tangential radius calculates the curvature at each point with respect to its neighboring point by fitting the best fit sphere. It does not refer to the optical axis, so there is less spherical bias. Tangential radius is of a greater accuracy in the peripheral cornea and is of better representation of local irregularities. Axial or sagittal map is the most commonly used one. It provides a good estimate of the overall corneal shape, which appears smooth with little noise because it provides an average of adjacent curvature values. Axial maps are the preferred clinical topographic default for routine diagnosis, screening for pathologists, IOL power calculation, and central corneal power measurement. Tangential or local maps are useful for evaluating the corneal shape, but it is not recommended for routine use because the measurement noise can obscure the true optical quality of the cornea. However, these tangential maps are extremely useful in demonstration and measurements in both surgical and pathological corneas. For example, in this case of keratoconus, in the axial map, the cone extends to peripheral, while in the tangential map, the cone is more localized and matches its clinical appearance. Curvature maps presentation. Topographically, corneas are classified into regular or irregular corneas according to its power and pattern appearance. The regular cornea has the following characteristics. The apex or steep portion of the cornea is close to its geometric center. There is a high degree of symmetry between the upper and the lower halves around the horizontal meridian. The cornea flattens towards the periphery, and the nasal cornea is slightly flatter than the temporal. The blue color appears earlier on the nasal side. Normal cornea has a relatively smooth bar contours. The power of normal cornea ranges from 42 to 44 diopters in the center and gradually flattens by 2 to 3 diopters towards the periphery. Normal cornea appears yellow or green. Warm or cool colors are abnormal. Topographic pattern. One should keep in mind that there is a wide spectrum of normality of human corneas, and regular corneas are either spherical or astigmatic. Spherical cornea has a round pattern, which indicates no significant astigmatism. This round pattern is located centrally, and the amount of displacement of the corneal center is less than 1 mm. Astigmatic cornea. Irregular corneal astigmatism is orthogonal, that's to say, Its major axes are perpendicular to each other. Also, it can be fully corrected with a cylinder or a spherocylinder lens. Most often, the corneal steep axis is vertical, that's to say with the rule astigmatism. Its magnitude or power is within normal limits. Astigmatic cornea can present as oval pattern or bow tie pattern. Oval means minimal astigmatism. Bow tie pattern have significant astigmatism but within the normal limits. These bow tie are either symmetric or slightly asymmetric. Symmetric means both loops of the bow tie are of the same size, shape and power. Topographies of fellow eye tend to be mirror image of each other. This is called enantiomorphism. The difference in pattern and the mean K is small. Irregular corneas. Topographically irregular corneal surface is not necessarily abnormal. Some normal corneas may appear irregular. Also, pathologically irregular corneas are not necessarily ectatic. Non-ectatic causes of irregular corneal surface include corneal degenerations, inflammation, dystrophies, and post-surgical. What are the topographic signs of irregularity? Irregularity can present as abnormal power or abnormal pattern. The asymmetric bow tie inferior steep. Normally, the cornea is slightly steeper inferiorly. The infrasuperior difference should not exceed plus 2 diopters at the middle circle. Abnormal inferior steepening is the commonest pattern in keratoconus. In this case, the steep area is located inferior or infratemporal to the corneal center. Clinically, patients with keratoconus exhibit unstable abnormal refraction and a significant decrease in best corrected visual acuity. Elevation maps are considered the cornerstone in detection of corneal ectasia. Anyhow, in a well-established ectasia such as keratoconus, the three maps, the curvature, the bathymetry, and the elevation, are abnormal. The three zones, the steep curvature, the thin bathymetry, and the abnormal back elevation are corresponding. This is called three-point touch. Asymmetric bow tie superior steep. In this pattern, the superior loop of the bow tie is larger and more powerful than the inferior loop. If the difference between the average superior and the average inferior values at the middle ring is greater than 2.5 diopters, it is abnormal. What is the hotspot syndrome? It is an area of relatively high power on the axial curvature map. Hot means hot colors, and it may be associated with other topographic or corneal abnormalities. The differential diagnosis includes ectatic and non-ectatic causes. Skewing. Skewing means the two segments of the bow tie are not aligned at the 3mm circuit. The bow tie may be symmetric or asymmetric. Asymmetric bow tie with a skewing more than 21 degrees is abnormal. And if associated with corneal astigmatism more than 1.5 diopters, is suggestive of keratoconus. This is called lazy eye pattern. What is a truncated symmetric bow tie? This is a short, high-power symmetric bow tie that rarely encountered in central keratoconus. Against the rule astigmatism. Bow tie along the horizontal corneal meridian is normal when there is no skewing, that's to say orthogonal astigmatism, and is of a normal power. On the other hand, horizontal bow tie with significant skewing or sagging and high power is a sign of early corneal ectasia. What is a crab claw? This crab claw or kissing bear's pattern is classically encountered in pellucid marginal degeneration and rarely met with in keratoconus. It indicates large amounts of against the rule astigmatism with inferior steepening, which creates an appearance of a C letter lying on its back. Pellucid marginal degeneration is diagnosed by its basonomanic bathymetry bell-shaped sign. In pellucid-like keratoconus, there is no bell sign. Thank you for attention. Waiting you in next lecture, inshallah.